Okay guys, welcome to another unboxing video. This is unboxing for the ZONETECH 12 volt heated electric lunchbox. Okay, and this one is a little bit different than the E-Ray that I also unboxed. This one, it says it'll go up to 300 degrees on the inside. This was recommended by Bob Wells on his cheap RV living YouTube channel. Now, he did say it was like Auto Pro or something like that. I looked for Auto Pro. I couldn't find any Auto Pro. This was the one I found, and it looks identical to the one that he showed in his video. So for this, it says to grill a sandwich. Grilled sandwich takes 7 to 10 minutes. That's what it says there. Soup, 20 minutes. Baby food, 3 to 5 minutes. So I guess if you're going to eat baby food, it's the quickest way. And hamburger, 5 minutes. Now, I don't think that's cooking the hamburger from raw. I'm thinking that that's just you throw in a Big Mac to keep it warm or whatever. Premium quality, easy to use, versatile, keeps food hot on long trips. So on the back here, it says the model number is a CT0001. And it's got a 2020 trademarks on it and stuff like that. So, yeah. Anyways, I'm going to crack this out of the box here, which I haven't done yet. This one only operates off of 12 volts. So it's strictly for using in the car. But I do have on my solar power system here, I do have a 12 volt cigarette lighter, two of them that come out of the actual battery compartment where the solar panel charges up the battery, and you know, has charge controller, and that's in another video. But it's right here, it's right behind this, it's this white box here has the battery in it, and then there's another box on top that holds a 1500 watt pure sine wave inverter and a 3000 watt modified sine wave inverter, and I got a huge AGM battery in the bottom of the box. So yeah, this plugs into 12 volts. It obviously doesn't use a lot of power because this cable is not super thick. I'm hoping somewhere here they have specifications, but it says it'll cook a turkey in 30 minutes. No way. No, that can't be right. Anyways, note, handling food, heating of foods improves with increased contact with the bottom plate. A water bath helps here. Some small oven bags or aluminum foil you can use in them for easy cook cleanup. Bob, when he showed his, he had these little aluminum trays that would fit inside it. But yeah, so yeah, it's aluminum. These are not removable. There is a rubber seal around here, I believe, is to keep the steam in. But yeah, so the unit should never be submersed in liquid. Keep the cord away from hot water or cold or hot surfaces. Do not bend the cord. Always unplug when not in use. Keep out of the reach of children, and use a light dishcloth to wipe clean. Alright, so in here, important. This unit can be operated on a 12 volt vehicle system. Also, start your vehicle engine prior to plugging in the ZONETECH portable road stove. Plug the cord into the cigarette lighter. This unit draws about 9 amps during operation, so make sure that the circuit you are using is rated for this much current. Average current draw is about 5 amps. The power cord has a 20 amp fuse installed in the end of the plug. It is recommended you replace the fuse with the same rating. Okay? Caution, do not use while driving. What? Do not use while driving? Well, that's the whole idea, is you plug it in and while you're driving it cooks your food. Do not warm food in plastic containers or sandwich bags or any sealed container. Plastic containers may melt. Sealed containers may explode from the heat. This unit must never be submersed in liquid. The bottom and the sides of the unit get extremely hot and steam may leak out. Okay, so anyways, it says here, internal thermostat maintains the temperature at 300 degrees Fahrenheit or 149 Celsius. Puncture cans and open jars prior to placing in the heating area. Place food in aluminum or small oven bags to make cleanup easier. You can safely put food into aluminum pans, however, cleanup may be more difficult. A water bath helps to spread the heat more quickly. Water must never be added while the unit is hot. Okay, so cooking examples. Baby food, 3 to 5 minutes. Hot dogs, 5 minutes. Grilled cheese sandwich, 7 to 10 minutes. Canned soup, 20 minutes. Rice, 30 minutes. Leftovers in an oven bag or foil varies depending on the type of food. So, the fact that it gets to 300 degrees, it should be able to boil water easily if it gets to 300 degrees. So yeah, there's a look inside. Pristine, because it's never been used. But, yeah. So I'll try this out, and if there's any negative consequences, I will definitely do another video on it. But, from what I understand, the recommendation that Bob Wells gave, that these are good little units. Yeah. So at least the information that was given on these is consistent throughout the... What the heck is that? Did somebody use it? Anyways, so yeah, I'm going to give this a whirl. I'm actually going to put my... So you could just crack the can, put a little bit of water in there, and close that up like that. And just, like he said, he just opens up a can of beans or a chili, throws a couple hot dogs in there and some tin foil, and fires it up. And, you know, 15 minutes later or so, your food is ready from a 12-volt source. So, better take this out of here. So yeah, there you have it. The what was the brand of this again? ZONETECH. You can buy this at zonetechauto.com, or you can buy it on Amazon, which is where I got it. And again, it was around 30 bucks. It wasn't super expensive. Yeah, looks pretty well made. So yeah, you may see me actually using this in various different videos, because I'm going to need to use this very shortly. Not too long from now. So anyways, guys, give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and leave a comment if you have any questions or anything like that. Leave a comment or a question in the comment section below. And if you're new to my channel, I would appreciate it very much if you would subscribe to me. Thank you very much for watching, and have a great day, guys.